Hi, I'm David Davis from Actual Tech Media. We're here at the headquarters of Backblaze, and I'm excited to be joined by Yev Pusin, who is the Director of Marketing. How you doing, Yev?
Doing well. Thank you for coming over and visiting.
Yeah, it's exciting. I'm a Backblaze customer myself, and so let's start off with this monster right here,
yeah.
The storage pod. Tell me what it is.
So this is kind of how all the magic happens. It's what stores all of our data. So we open sourced the design back in 2009. That was kind of what a lot of folks knew us for the longest time. Now it's a mixture of this and hard drive stats, but this is how we store everything. So any data that a customer sends to us, we have a couple different products. So on the online backup and business backup side, anything sent to us from our client gets encrypted, gets stored on these things. If someone needs it, they go to our website, creates a restore or recovers it, that data gets sent to them, either with a zip or a USB hard drive. On the B2 side, which is object storage,
okay,
you send the data to us however you want. It gets stored on one of these beautiful things. It all gets sharded across 20 like pods, and then gets safely and securely stored in the data center.
Okay, so the pictures of my kids are on one of these in the data center somewhere.
They're actually on 20 of these.
20 of these, okay.
Yeah, so how it works, it's a process called read Solomon erasure coding, and much like everything else, we've also kind of disclosed how we do that, because it's not really that big of a secret, it's just mathematics. So you upload a picture of your kid, it gets sharded into 20 different, essentially, chunks.
Right.
Each chunk is kept on a hard drive on 20 different storage pods.
Wow.
So if any, and those pods, by the way, are kept in different racks. So we can lose a bunch of racks without losing any data.
Yeah.
And then we use the magic math to rebuild all those files if we do have such an event.
Wow. Yeah. Thank goodness for magic math.
Exactly.
So why was it that you all created this?
So that's a great question. At the beginning of Backblaze, folks, when we came out of the gate and we said, yeah, it's $5 a month, it's unlimited data, you can back up whatever you want, people kind of scratched their heads and went like, well, how are you doing that? That's mathematically not possible. And so we open sourced the storage pod design, which was like, hey, this is actually how we're doing it. At the time, it only had 45 drives. This one is one of our newer ones, so it has 60 bays. But at 45, it just had three of these little guys in it. And we said, look, at 1 terabyte drives, we can fit 45 drives in here. That's 45 terabytes, and it cost us about $12,000 to do it, which was at the time kind of unheard of. If you remember, in 2009, that was before like the Open Compute and the Open Connect standards were created by Netflix and Facebook, and no one was really doing this. We were kind of one of the first ones to say, like, this is exactly the type of storage that we need. We need to ingest a bunch of data, hold on to it, and then get it back to people should they need it. We don't need it to do anything fancier than that. And so we had to build our own, because at the time, one of the things we were thinking about doing was, well, if we want to store data for $5 a month, we could maybe use Amazon's infrastructure, because S3 was around at the time, it was still early. But we realized that at $5 a month, we would only be able to store about 50 gigabytes of data before we started losing money.
And that's not a very good deal.
No, and we were bootstrapped, right? So some companies can do that because they can burn, you know, VC cash, but for us at the time, we didn't have that. So we needed something that could make us make money and be profitable as an actual business right out the gate. And so we designed this, and the first iteration, because we didn't know what we were doing. Everyone that started the company was a software person, and here we are making hardware. The first iteration was actually just a bunch of USB drives, external ones, connected to a hub, because someone read that you can do up to 180 USB drives before the standard kind of breaks down. In practice, it's closer to like 6, but,
really?
But they didn't know.
Yeah.
And then we built one of these guys out of wood, which is not great for a data center, so no one would actually accept that, but it was a prototype, and we were testing out the backplanes and how everything would kind of work together, and would it all talk together should we boot it. That worked, so we found someone to bend the sheet metal. Then came this beautiful big red box that we're kind of known for to this day. So really, it kind of came out of necessity.
Absolutely, and it's really the engine that allows you, I mean, besides the software, to be a profitable and very successful company.
Yeah, definitely. Without this kind of, you know, it doesn't work. And not this, but a server like this, right? So we made our own. There are now other companies that are producing like servers at similar price points, but it didn't exist at the time, right?
Yeah.
So we kind of trailblazed a little bit. for something that we needed. And it enables us to provide all of our services. So like we have the online backup in Backblaze for Business, which is $5 a month. It's unlimited data, right, for Macs and PCs. So that one's really simple. And because most people don't store a bunch of data, we make that work. And it works with our, you know, with our average costs. Then we also have B2, which you kind of see behind us. And that's half a penny per gigabyte a month. And that's object-based cloud storage. So it's like a quarter of the cost of Amazon S3 or Azure or Google Cloud. And we can all make that happen with these beautiful red guys.
Awesome. So online storage, unlimited for $5 a month for consumers and businesses for Macs and PCs, and then B2 cloud storage, object storage. It's all stored in the beautiful storage pod here.
That's right.
Thank you so much for your time today.
Yeah, absolutely. Thank you.